The Kissing Booth, based on the best-selling novel by Beth Reekles, became a must-see on Netflix starring Joey King, Jacob Elordi, and Joel Courtney back in 2018, and the sequel was also successful. Besides Ellie's long-distance relationship with Noah, finishing up her college applications, and maintaining her relationship with bestie Lee, she also has caught the attention and eventually the heart of the newest boy in town, Marco. While watching the sequel and captivating scenes, there are things you probably missed, and Riveted has compiled all those moments. Ellie's real name. Some fans may not have realized Ellie isn't the lead's full first name. It's Rochelle, and her name appears on the college applications. We also hear it in the film once when Noah says, "I'm sorry, Rochelle," after she tells him she got waitlisted from Berkeley and Harvard, even though viewers know she got into both colleges. The disappearance of Ellie's interest. In the kissing booth, Ellie makes it pretty clear that she loves soccer, and she's even on the school soccer team. In the sequel, that plotline basically disappears. There's no mention of soccer or any scenes where Ellie is at practice or in uniform. Speaking of Ellie, did you notice that she was basically not doing much in the summer? Somehow, even though it's the summer before Ellie's senior year of high school, she's not working or completing an internship or doing anything to boost her college applications, which is especially surprising since she later applies to an Ivy League college. She spends the summer with Noah at his parents' beach house without any parental supervision. Filming location. Despite the film being set in California, a lot of it was actually filmed in Cape Town, South Africa. The University of Cape Town was a filming location for the college and school scenes. The amazing house with the dinner scene at the Flynn family home was also filmed in Cape Town, South Africa. The Flynn home, where Noah and Lee grew up, has actually already appeared in another Netflix original. The house's exterior appears in the 2019 Black Mirror episode, Rachel, Jack, and Ashley 2. It's where the character Ashley O lives. You might recognize the villa further because it's the same place where the winter version of UK Love Island was filmed. Obviously, it gets a very big makeover for Love Island, so it looks very different. Mean Girls vibe. The OMG girls are everything Ellie isn't. Vacuous, obsessed with looks and fame, but that doesn't mean she doesn't want to impress them. And when it comes to the OMG girls, we think we've seen something similar before, more than 20 years ago. The trio of popular girls at Ellie and Lee's high school have more than a passing resemblance to the plastics in the Mean Girls. Also, in the kissing booth, OMG girl Mia is played by actress Jessica Sutton. In the sequel, Sutton has been replaced by actress Camilla Wolfson. Also, you may or may not have noticed that Chloe mentioned the Debele tribe from Zimbabwe when she was talking to her friends. Netflix probably thought we won't notice that the Mean Girls mentioned the same tribe when the fertility vase was referenced. Heather from the first film. Heather, who shows Ellie the video of Marco and then lets her go on her rant about how hot he is over the school's intercom system, was actually in this first film too. Heather was kissing Noah at a party in the kissing booth. Joey King wears wigs. It's nearly impossible to tell, but King is wearing a wig during the sequel. She had shaved her head for her leading role in Hulu's series The Act right before filming The Kissing Booth 2, so she had to wear wigs to keep her look as Ellie. Guess what? Her wigs even had names. King named two of them Ralph and Mrs. Fletcher. Makeup designer Krista Showman named the third wig Delilah. Shooting with an IRLX. Jacob Elordi and Joey King dated when the first movie came out, but went their separate ways after a year. They were frequently spotted by paparazzi out together, and the two posted about their relationship on social media constantly. Although they are in a long-distance relationship in the film, Ellie and Noah also have some pretty intense love scenes. Doing all those scenes with a real-life ex is just mind-blowing. Noah's room doesn't have a doorknob. Noah's dorm room is pretty fancy, even for an Ivy League college like Harvard. It has a fireplace, leather couch, huge bed, and fancy decor. But his door doesn't have a doorknob. This could explain how Chloe ended up borrowing Noah's bed without asking him or having his key, but it doesn't make sense for a college dorm. Same first day of school. The beginning of Ellie's first day of school for senior year basically mirrors her first day of junior year. Just like in the first movie, Ellie is wearing a skirt instead of pants. She's in a rush to leave, so she grabs breakfast quickly, gives her dad and brother speedy goodbye hugs, and gets picked up by Lee. The only difference is that in the sequel, the skirt actually fits, which Lee makes a nod to in the second movie when he gives Ellie a tiny skirt. Also, like in the first movie, she's welcomed with whispers. In the first film, they were gossiping about her skirt, but in the second one, they're talking about her rumored breakup with Noah. Notable nods. Ellie kicks off the movie under the Hollywood sign, which is where she and Noah spent their first night together. In the sequel, though, Ellie is there alone, and instead of starting a new chapter in a relationship with Noah, she seemingly put it on pause. Ellie and Noah also reunited in the same spot where they had their first kiss in the kissing booth, the gazebo at the park. In the first movie, they have a dramatic kiss in the rain under the gazebo in the park after kissing for the first time in the booth. In the sequel, no one interrupts them. Another nod was when Ellie visited Noah in Boston. They get a romantic dinner at Mama Maria. This is a real Italian restaurant located in Boston's North End. What's wrong with Noah? First of all, he gets overly concerned when Ellie doesn't answer his texts at a time when she's supposed to be in class. Noah, people in high school don't normally immediately answer texts when they are in class. And calling the school? Come on. Ellie is told that her father called the office, but when she leaves class to pick up the call, it's actually Noah, who called her school, pretending to be her father, just to ask why she's been guarded over text. There's no clear reasoning behind why he has to call her at this exact moment instead of just waiting until she's out of school. Noah accidentally hit an extra. When Noah met Ellie at the Boston airport, he was holding a sign saying her name and "I miss you more" on the back. As she ran towards him to give him a hug, Noah flung the sign behind him, hitting an extra with a backpack who was walking by. Nobody even checked to see if he was okay. Jeez. Harvard standards. Honestly, if it was as easy to get into Harvard like it's portrayed in the movie, we'd all go to Harvard. What's happening with Noah's Instagram? His Insta is called @NoahNonsense12 with the bio "Fast Bikes, Football, Ice Cream Sundays." Okay, for someone at Harvard University, that fake Insta is a total mess. Mark Zuckerberg created Facebook in the same walls where Noah is learning. How Ellie got into Harvard is also quite questionable. Imagine getting accepted to Harvard writing, "I have no idea what I want to be in 5 years," and then listing a bunch of qualities belonging to people whom the admissions office has no idea exist. Olivia finally kissed Melvin. In the kissing booth, Olivia is supposed to kiss the class oddball Melvin. She doesn't want to, so she forces Ellie out there instead, which is how Ellie and Noah end up kissing. In the sequel, though, Olivia ends up kissing him at the kissing booth for real, and she doesn't mind it. Ellie's misplaced sympathy. Ollie was one of Ellie and Lee's classmates in the first movie, but he didn't have any significant moments. In the sequel, Ellie sees Ollie smile at their fellow classmate Miles and realizes that Ollie is falling for him. Ellie assures him that she understands what he's going through because she was hiding hooking up with Noah the previous year. How in the world did she think that coming out as a gay was the same as avoiding her best friend's brother? Other than Ollie confessing his feelings for Miles to Ellie on the beach, this plotline went unnoticed for much of the film. It isn't until Ollie gets ready to kiss a girl at the kissing booth that he decides to walk away from the booth and go kiss Miles instead. Well, it still seems a little problematic that Ellie put Ollie in that awkward position of working the kissing booth after he came out to her. New talents. A few scenes throughout the kissing booth too feature Marco playing guitar and singing. It was really actor Zakhar Perez playing, though he'd never played guitar before filming began. The actor said his guitar lessons took 3 hours each day. Richard Sincelles also makes Chloe look like a pro pool player, even though the actress learned how to play shortly before filming. She actually prepared for the movie by training with a champion pool player. The Dance Dance Mania. In case you didn't notice, the prize for winning the competition was $50,000. For reference, the competition has prize money equivalent to Love Island, the biggest reality TV show in the UK. And it just happens to be the exact amount Ellie needs to go to college. How convenient. The arena the competition takes place in is huge, and there is an impressive audience of 2,000 extras, according to Netflix, gathered to watch. The stage even has fire and sparklers shooting up during the dances. Everyone in the competition is also taking it very seriously with their well-choreographed routines and elaborate costumes. In all honesty, the scene is pretty ridiculous and dramatic for a random arcade game competition. Marco and John Ambrose. Please tell us we are not the only ones who noticed the similarities between Marco and John Ambrose from To All the Boys I've Loved Before. Both were side love interests who materialized in the sequel, both disrupted seemingly dreamy relationships when the boyfriends went off to college, and both were seen as the nice guys of the films. They also had musical talents, and unfortunately, they were both not chosen at the end of the films. Still, on Marco. Considering we have no idea where Marco is going to college, is there a chance that Marco and Ellie can end up in the same college together with or without Noah? Other than the things you probably missed, there are some questions that were left unanswered from the sequel, like why did Ellie decide to not only kiss Marco but to kiss him on a competition being filmed on live TV? And why does every time Noah texts Ellie, it appears on her phone like it's the first time they've ever texted? The good news is we are going to get a third installment. This final scene gives the movie an unsatisfying ending that clearly sets us up for a third film in the series where Ellie will have to decide which school to go to, a conflict that will surely lead to even more drama in her life. Netflix already confirmed another sequel, and fans can't wait. The surprise announcement on July 26th came with the news that The Kissing Booth 3 had already been filmed back-to-back with the sequel, and that meant the current global situation won't affect its release. While we don't have an exact release date yet, we do know that The Kissing Booth 3 will arrive in 2021 on Netflix. If the sequel's ending didn't make it clear, the third movie synopsis confirms that it'll evolve around Ellie's major decision. Beth Reekles has yet to release a third Kissing Booth book, so fans face an agonizing wait to see if Ellie chooses Harvard to be with Noah or Berkeley to deliver on her promise to Lee. So, what surprised you from The Kissing Booth 2? Are you looking forward to The Kissing Booth 3? Let us know in the comments section below. This has been Riveted, and we publish amazing videos daily.